hello everyone and welcome to Quiz Whiz Junior. My name is SJ Lee.
Thank you so much for joining us once again. My name is Angela Park. So SJ, before we start, kind of a personal question. How many friends do you have?
How many friends do I have?
Family doesn't count.
I have three friends.
Three friends. Okay, well, believe it or not, there are also three categories of friends, apparently. There's the foodie type friend who you share meals with and eat with, right? There's also the medicine type of friend who you go to occasionally when you need them. Then there's the plague type friend who you want to avoid at all costs. So which one are you?
I am going to guess, judging by my weight, I am the foodie friend.
Great. I need a free meal later today. I'll call you.
All right.
But I want to add one more category.
Okay.
So being that we provide, of course, weekly fun and education to our viewers, I think there should be a weekly special friend like Quiz Whiz Junior.
Oh, that's right. Of course, we have 16 new friends that are going to be meeting in our program today here on Quiz Whiz Junior. So let's meet our friends and our contestants. Now, first up, we're going to be introducing our first team, the four Quizketeers from Pundang Elementary School with Mina, Seoyeon, Chaeyun, and Jaehee.
We're fast, smart, we compete with others, and we win.
Go for Quizketeers!
And next, we have hailing from Sinchon Elementary, we have team Do Dream with Minjung, Chanu, Minjung, and Hyungji.
We will never lose
fighting!
And of course, up third, they are Team N-Stars from the Seoul Buksung Elementary School with Yebin, Jiu, Yeju, and Jae.
We are the N-Stars shining bright.
We'll lead the
way to victory.
And last but definitely not least, hailing from Incheon Buhyundong Elementary, introducing Team Sun, we have Minseo, Seungche, Yeji, and Jaehee.
Go for it!
All right, four teams, 16 contestants, and 16 friends and two hosts, right? We are ready to get started with part one or round one of Quiz Whiz Junior. This is Go Go Go! Go. Go.
We are starting off round one where time can either be your friend or enemy. This is Go, Go, Go. 60 seconds on the clock. We have one clue giver from each team trying to get their teammates to guess as many words correctly in the given time.
That's right. Time does tick very, very quickly. And of course, the clue givers and the guessers will have to do a great teamwork with this. So before the program, of course, we chose who was going to go first, second, third, and fourth using the words Q-U-I-Z. And the team that picked the letter Q, N-Star, will be coming up first. So why don't you guys head over? Let's go, go, go. All right, Team N-Star is ready to go with the first go, 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 led by our clue giver, Jay. So we have 60 seconds on the clock. Let's go, go, go.
This part of the body.
Hand.
We used it to send mails.
Pencil.
Okay, use the word within the answer.
We send, it's the, this part of the clothes. We use this to do our hair.
Brain?
No, we
brush.
Yeah. This is the
head.
This is the bottom, and this is the brain. This is the bottom, and this is the... It's a ball game where you roll a ball. Yeah. We go for a walk there, and we take our dog sometimes, and...
Pet!
No.
And time.
Well, you guys were able to get three words there. Congratulations.
And having selected the letter U, we have Team Sun, and it's your turn, so please come on down. And Team Sun is ready, and I do believe we have Jaehee as the clue giver. Jaehee, are you ready?
Yes.
They're ready. Let's go and get them started. 60 seconds, please.
Piss.
Piss. We're when we're going to the school, we have to
bag.
The long. Oh, when we sing this, this is a transportation. This is where.
Airplane.
No, we are sick. The hospital.
Chair. Ambulance.
Oh, we have to diet to this. Pass. Oh, if we put the, this one, this trees grow up.
Seed.
Time is up. You guys were able to get two words worth 40 points. Good job, guys. And going third, they chose the letter I. They're going third. This is for Quizketeers. So why don't you guys step on right up? The four Quizketeers are coming up next with their third team here. There's 60 seconds on the clock. Let's go, go, go.
The month after February.
March.
It's a sport that boys like. That they
soccer.
The opposite of no.
Yes.
Mother and
father.
It's a bear that has black spots on it and white.
Panda.
You set this and it's like a clock and it rings when the
alarm
time's up.
Clock.
Pass. It's pig meat.
Pork?
The other one. Pass. It's like street. Street.
Pass.
It's a person who fishes.
Wow, six words.
Not bad.
Good job, guys. And we're going to be inviting our last team out there. This is Do Dream.
Do Dream is ready, and we have our clue giver. Now, if you notice, we do have Minjung A, mm-hmm. and we should point out it's because there are two Minjungs on the team.
That's right.
Right.
They both have the same last name. So it's Minjung A and Minjung B. And Minjung A is going to be our clue giver. So we'll give them 60 seconds on the clock. Let's go, go, go.
What is this?
Jump.
There are many animals here. Jew. Like my mom.
Female?
Cook.
Yes.
Pass. Like there's no hair on
head.
Pass.
What is this?
It's here, this part.
Pass.
And we write
your pencil?
No, there's a green board and we write something with this.
Pass.
Well, you guys were able to get three words there worth 60 points, so let's get you guys back up there.
That would be a wrap on round one of Go, 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 and we're already starting to see some differences or gaps in scores. Let's get a score recap.
That's right. Right now, four Quizketeers in first place right now with 120 points here. Do Dream in second place with 60 points. And Star, they're also tied with Do Dream with 60 points. Sun, you guys are not too far back. 40 points, third place.
All right, so we have our second round, and we call it
True or False. It's round two of Quiz Whiz Junior, which means it's time for True or False. All of our contestants will be taking a listen to five different True or False statements. All they have to do is simply press X for false, O for true.
That's right. Pretty simple. And once again, each statement or question is worth 20 points. Let's get started then. We have our first statement. Listen very carefully.
In Greek mythology, Icarus had wings constructed from feathers and wax.
Mythology. Ooh, do we have some mythology fans out there? You don't have all the time in the world. 3 seconds, let's get your answers in now.
Very nice. It was almost simultaneous in timing and in the answer. They all guessed or answered true.
That's right. And the answer is...
It is indeed true, because we often hear the saying, Icarus, that he was told to not fly close to the sun because obviously wax would melt.
That's right. Well, true was the answer here. So let's see if they could get the next statement correct as well. Let's take a listen to our second true or false statement.
The first mammal to ever be cloned in the world was a goat.
They are thinking, some answering going on.
You have 3 seconds. Let's get your answers in. Is it true or false?
All right. So once again, all four teams seem to be on the same page answering that it is false.
That's right. So the answer is...
Yes, they all knew the answer.
That's right. I think the first mammal that was cloned was not a goat.
No.
But it was, I believe it was named Dolly.
That's right.
And it was a sheep. So this one was pretty tricky, but no, it was a sheep and her name was Dolly.
Very nice to all four teams. Third statement, please.
The part of the onion we eat is the stem.
Well, being that I'm the foodie friend, I should know this, right?
And onions, very commonly used in Korean cooking.
That's right. 3 seconds on the clock. Let's get your answers in now.
Ooh. Very close call, but Sun made their answer go in right at the last second.
That's right. We have two trues
yes.
and two falses.
Let's find out.
It's true.
It is true.
It is the stem. So Dewdream and N-Star, they both get 20 points each. Now, let's take a listen to our next true or false question.
People who weigh less experience more gravity than those who weigh more.
Now,
science.
Think.
This is pretty tricky. People who weigh less experience more gravity than those who weigh more. Is it true or false? 3 seconds, let's get your answers in now.
All right, so false was the answer that they're all going with. Let's find out if they're all correct. Yes.
That's right. People who weigh less will actually experience less gravity, right?
That's right. So heavier you are, the heavier the earth will feel you as well.
Yeah, let's not try that here. Right? All right. Our fifth true or false statement. Let's take a listen.
Japan is the host country for the 2018 FIFA World Cup.
Any soccer fans? They may know the answer.
It's coming up shortly in 2 years. 3 seconds on the clock. Let's get your answers in now. Sun, unable to get the answer in just in time, right?
That's right.
But the other three teams said, no, it's false.
Yep, they're going with false on this one. So let's find out if Japan is indeed going to be hosting in 2 years' time.
It is false.
That's right. It's not going to be Japan. It's actually going to be Russia will be hosting.
And of course, in 4 years, it's the 2020 Tokyo Summer Olympics. So it might have been a little bit tricky, right? Well, false was the answer there. Well, that was the final statement we heard.
That's right. So 5 statements out. Let's get a recap on the scores. We have 4 Quizketeers maintaining their spot in first place. They have 200 points. And then still tied for second, we have Du You Dream with 160 points. And then, of course, N-Star also with 160 points. Sun is still very, very close behind with 100 points.
That's right, Sun. I do want to say that, you know, there are many, many points to be earned. So, you know, that's not a big deficit there. So you guys definitely have a chance to come back. So speaking of which, you can come back with the next round that's coming up. This is Word Up.
Here we are already at Word Up. Now, this is the round where we will be giving one category 15 words scrambled up, and our contestants have to unscramble them in 60 seconds.
That's right. It is pretty tricky, especially when the clock is ticking. It's going tick, 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 and all four of them are trying to work at the same time.
Yep.
Well, team chemistry is very important, so we'll see how well they work together. 60 seconds on the clock. Let's see those words. Camping. That's the category here. I see some words there.
Yeah, I do too. Now, camping has become very popular in Korea in recent years. In fact, you know what's number one on my husband's to-buy list? It's a camping car. I told him, let's wait a little on that.
That's pretty expensive. But you know what? There's so many different kinds of camping as well. These days, there's things like glamping, right?
Yes, that's right. For people who don't like to rough it as much, right?
That's right. Well, there's not a lot of time on the clock right now. 25 seconds. A lot of discussing going on.
We have a slightly louder bunch than usual in the discussion arena. I'm looking forward to seeing if that was effective in their word unscrambling.
Less than 10 seconds. Let's get those final words in there.
3 seconds.
And markers down. And lift up your boards. Let's see them. Lift them up nice and proudly. Well, all of us here at Quiz Whiz Junior, all the staff members got all busy checking all the words that were unscrambled, and we got our results.
All right, let's hear them.
Yeah, before we do hear them, though, we do want to see what the answers are, because there are some that they missed. So let's take a look at the answers after it's been unscrambled. Oh, man.
15 words, and yep, those are all very commonly associated with camping.
We'll see how many words each team were able to get. Now, first off, for Quizketeers, they were able to get 10 different words. Now, Do Dream, they were very close. They were also able to get somewhere near there, 9 different words. N-Star, we're able to get the most number of words with 11.
Wow.
Sun, you guys did a great job as well. You guys got 7 different words.
Lucky 7.
So kudos to all of you guys. Now, we saw some change in the scoring right now, so why don't we take a look at the scores right now?
Yeah, we still do have 4 Quizketeers in first place with 400 points. But now we have a shift. Second place, N-Star with 380 points. Do Dream, still not far behind with 340 points, and Sun bringing in an impressive 240 points.
That's right, but once again, we have many, many points to earn, especially in the final round of the first half of Quiz Whiz Junior. You
That's
could get
right.
50, 40, 30, it doesn't matter. Let's get you closer into the race here. Speaking of which, let's go into our next round. This is
What Am I?
Riddle me this, riddle me that. This is round 4 with What Am I? The riddle segment.
That's right. 5 riddles have been prepared for our contestants. Now, depending on how many hints they need to answer each riddle, they can earn anywhere from up to even 50 points.
That's right. Those 50 pointers are pretty tricky, but it can help you out in getting those points. So, obviously, the more hints you use, the less points you're going to earn, but hey, at this point, each point counts.
That's right. That was a lot of wordplay there. Good job. All right. If you guys are ready, we have your first riddle. Listen carefully to our first hint.
I am arranged in a specific order and sequence.
All right, you have two letters. Now remember, you only get one chance with each riddle.
Now I see some discussion. We are going to have to give you 3 seconds.
Oh, sun! Last minute. The answer, please.
We're gonna need something.
3 seconds.
Quick with the buzzer, but unfortunately not quite ready.
That's right. They really wanted the 50-pointer, but they lost their chance. Well, let's take a listen to our 40-point hint.
I am smart.
That was our second hint. Unfortunately, Sun is no longer able to answer for this riddle.
That's right. Still three teams in the run for this one. There's a lot of discussion going on, but not a lot of time. 3 seconds on the clock.
We are going to have to bring that down to 30 points now. Here's your next hint.
You can find me on the internet.
At this point right now, there's a lot of letters, so it's kind of like word up. All you have to do is, oh, do dream.
Dictionary.
Dictionary.
Everyone, the second time we said dictionary, that makes sense.
Well, it was worth 30 points, but for all the teams out there, don't worry. There's more questions out there. Let's take a listen to our next riddle.
I need two people in order to move.
Okay, not much to work with. That is why this one would be worth 50 points.
None of the hands are shifting towards the buzzer. It is pretty tough. 3 seconds.
Yep.
Can't blame them, right?
That was tricky. Okay, let's get a little more help.
All right, here's our 40-point hint.
I require good balance.
Sun.
Seesaw.
Seesaw.
Wow!
Yes. Worth 40 points. Good job, Sun. Seesaw.
All right, that was great for Sun. Let's get the next riddle.
I shine bright at night.
This one's a pretty long word here, but you have two letters in the first hint.
Once again, nobody going towards the buzzer. 3 seconds.
All right, like I said, the answer seems like a long one there, and there's not much to work with, but maybe with our second hint. This is our 40-point hint.
Sometimes people are inside me. Sometimes they are not.
Okay, four letters revealed now. Anybody want 40 points? Up for grabs in 3 seconds.
All right, no 40-pointer, but maybe this time 30-pointer will help. This is our third hint. Let's take a listen.
My shape resembles a tower.
End star.
Lighthouse.
Lighthouse.
Very nice. You can usually tell or predict if the answer is correct or not because you hear a amongst the rest of the students, right?
Exactly, and we did hear it, and that was the answer, lighthouse. All right, 30 points for N-Star. Here's our fourth riddle. Let's take a listen.
I can be found in space.
A lot of things are found in space. It's a very big space.
Yes, the space has a lot of space. That is true. But what we don't have is a lot of time. 3 seconds. All right, still no one going for the 50-pointer just yet. But let's see if anyone gets it with our 40-point hint. Let's take a listen.
I can be a meeting place for people.
Sun.
Station.
Station.
Wow! Wow! Sun is very good at pulling apart these riddles. Great job. That was worth 40 points.
One more last riddle, so let's take a listen.
There are numbers that represent me.
The letter U. Still no team getting the 50-pointer.
I want to give them just a couple more seconds before I say the dreaded three seconds. Okay.
All right. Let's see if they can get it with our second hint. This is worth 40 points. Let's take a listen.
TK is the Greek goddess that governed me.
Do dream. 3 seconds. Seems like he had the answer at the tip of his tongue, but no. Well, okay. Do Dream is out. 3 seconds on the clock once again.
No other takers.
All right. Well, this next one is going to be worth 30 points, so let's take a listen.
Murphy's Law goes against what I stand for.
Aha. Yes, N-Star.
N-Star.
Fiction.
Fiction.
Friction.
Friction.
Friction. Friction. Is it
friction? Oh,
no,
and she knew she got it wrong, which means Sun and 4 Quizketeers are the only ones in on this. 30 points, anyone. 3 seconds on the clock.
Nobody. Okay, we are bringing it down, but hey, every little bit counts, so 20 points.
People hope for me when they buy lottery tickets.
All right.
Fortune.
That was indeed correct.
That's right, that was worth 20 points, which makes a slight difference. That is going to conclude the final part of the first half of Quiz Whiz Junior.
All right, that would bring us to the final score recap for the first half. And maintaining their first place spot all the way for Quizketeers with 420 points.
That's right. They were actually in second place right before they got that 20-pointer because N-Star finishes in second place. They're going to move on along with 4 Quizketeers to have 410 points.
That's right. Do Dream, 370 points. Great effort on your part. And Sun, 320 points. We loved that last-minute splurge, but unfortunately, we will have to part with you in the first half.
That's right. And of course, Sun, Do Dream, they did do a great job. Unfortunately, they won't be joining us in the second half, but instead, we'll have 4 Quizketeers and N-Star. They're going to be joining us in the second half of Quiz Whiz Junior, right?
That's right. So congratulations to our finalist teams, and let's also give a round of applause to all 4 teams for their great effort.
My favorite corner was What Am I, because I can get most score at this corner. Well, I'm Rose, and however, I like this channel.
재미있었긴 했는데 많이 실력이 부족했던 것 같아요.
It was a great time because we knew each other, and even where we lose this game, but it was a great time.
And welcome to the second half of Quiz Whiz Junior. It was an exciting first round. We have our 2 finalist teams starting us off with Team Showdown. We have, of course, 4 Quizketeers and N-Star still with us.
It depends on who gets eliminated. And as long as one team has at least one member left in their team, they are going to be the winners.
And I do believe we have picked out the first contestant that will be going.
That's right. The 4 Quizketeers, Jaehee, will be choosing her first opponent. Ooh. Who is it going to be, Jaehee?
It'll be Jay.
Oh. Jaehee versus Jay. Let's get Jaehee and Jaehee in front of the mics with our first question.
Tropical cyclones have different names according to where they occur. What is the word that goes in the blank? Indian Ocean cyclone. Oceans around North and Central America's blank. Northwest Pacific Ocean, typhoon.
J.
Hurricane.
Hurricane, is that the answer?
Yes, absolutely. All three talking about the same phenomenon, but of course, different names.
Jaehee, you have just been eliminated. But now, Jay, who is your next opponent?
Seoyeon.
Seoyeon, all right. Seoyeon and Jaehee, let's switch places. Carefully listen to our next question.
The following describes an organ from the adult human body. What is the name of this organ? Volume, approximately 1500 cc. External shape, J-shaped. Function, a storage tank for food where partial digestion takes place. Characteristic.
J.
Stomach.
Stomach.
Is it?
It is.
That's right. Very important organ.
Jay was able to eliminate Seoyeon, which means two members yes. of the four Quizketeers have been eliminated. Right now, Jay, who is your next opponent?
Mina.
Mina? Jay is proving to be quite the force to be reckoned with. She has two on her record so far.
Let's hear a cheer for Mina.
They have masks covering their mouth. So Mina, let's see if you can make them proud. Next question.
There is one word that fits in all the blank spaces. What is this word? Blank card. Card signaling caution or penalty. Blank pages, type of telephone directory, blank dust, weather-related event.
Jay again.
Red.
Is it red? No, I'm sorry. Oh.
Mina.
Yellow.
Yellow.
Yes, that is right. I have a question, though, for our contestants.
Yes.
Do you know what the yellow pages are?
No.
Exactly. I'm not surprised.
It used to be in every house you get a book like this thick and it's the color yellow and it has all your telephone numbers for homes and businesses. This was before the internet, right?
That's right. And also, you know, we had to memorize people's numbers and if we can't find it, I have to call Angela. What's her number again? Well, let's look for it. That's how we found it.
That's right. In the, you know, dinosaur era, where we're from. But a great job to Mina. Who do you select for your next opponent?
Yeju.
Yeju. Let's get the next question.
The following is a list of countries. Which two nations do not have presidents? United States of America, United Kingdom, Japan.
Mina.
United Kingdom and Japan.
United Kingdom and Japan, BNC. That is correct.
Absolutely correct. That's right.
That's right. The UK, they have a prime minister.
That's right.
In Japan, they also have a prime minister. But in the UK, they have Queen Elizabeth II. Mm-hmm. And of course, Japan still has Emperor Akihito. That's
yes.
right. Wow.
All right. Great knowledge from Mina's part. Mina, your next opponent?
Jiu.
Jiu. Take a listen to our next question.
Fill in the blank. Baseball, bat, archery.
Mina.
Bow.
Bow.
Yes.
Wow, she is on quite a run here.
She's very quick to buzz in as well. I didn't even see her hand move, but I heard the noise.
Oh, Jiu, unfortunately, this is going to be it, which means there is one last member of the N-Stars left over. It's Yebin.
Yes. And we have our last member of N-Star, Yebin, and we have our question ready, so let's hear it.
What is the number that the following words have in common. Octopus, solar system, octave.
Mina.
Eight.
Eight.
Man, she's fast.
And that's the answer, and she just eliminated all the N-Star contestants.
Wow.
All right, before we do move on to the next round, let's take a look at the scores so far. Mina really did help out her team with the four Quizketeers.
Absolutely, and she looks pretty proud of herself at that. Four Quizketeers leading the way with 400 points. Now N-Star with 200, but this is like our mantra. It's not over till it's over because we have future rounds with many, 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 many more points to earn.
That's right. There's always room to come back, and I'm pretty sure they will. Now, speaking of which, I'll try to come back with our next round here. Round two is Brain Flash. Now, this is round two with Brain Flash, where all of our contestants have to really dig into the memory portion of their brain to try to memorize as many flashcards as you can. 12 to be exact,
yes, that's
in 15
right.
seconds.
Not very long at all, so our contestants have to be quick. Now, if you take a look at our two teams, they are geared up. Mm-hmm. I see for the Quizketeers, we have Chen that will be memorizing and Soyeon that will be guessing the common word.
As for the N-Star, it's going to be Yebin. She's going to guess, while, of course, for her teammate, Chiu is going to do the memorizing.
All right. We have our two teams ready, so let's get our words. Five seconds left.
Time is up. Once again, 15 seconds gone like that.
Mm-hmm. So I do believe Four Quizketeers was in the lead,
That's
or they
right.
are, so they will go first.
That's right. So Chaeyun is going to go first with the first word. Tell us.
Forest.
Forest. Chiu.
Bird's nest.
Bird's nest.
Paper. Canadian flag.
That's correct.
Axe.
Tell us on there.
Ute. Oxygen.
You thinking about it. 3 seconds.
Okay, Chaeyun, do you have any more? Oh, fair game.
All right, she also doesn't have any more. So we're going to flip those over, and Sayan will go first and try to guess what word all of these clues have in common.
Fortunately, Chaeyun, she was able to memorize a few words for you to work with here.
That's right, four clues to be exact. So let's flip them over, and hopefully this will be of help.
Tree.
Tree. All right, they have tree for the four Quizketeers. Let's find out if that's the answer. But before that, we're going to help Yebin now take out her headphones and her mask. Let's help her out, guys.
All right, so Yebin, if you are ready, we are ready to show you the words that Chiu was able to memorize.
All right, what do these three clue words have in common? What is that one word we're looking for?
We have bird's nest, Canadian flag, and of course, Korean traditional game, yut, yunnori, right?
National.
National. All right. We have tree and national. Now, before we do reveal the answer, let's take a look at the other pictures and words that our contestants weren't able to memorize.
Now, this should clear it up a little bit more. Let's get the big answer reveal, please. It was tree.
That's right. That means that not only do you get the points for getting some of the words that you memorized, but you also get 100 points for the word that was in common for the four Quizketeers. But it's not over yet because our contestants are going to switch around.
That's right. So the two contestants that had to stay silent, you get your chance. Let's switch gears, please.
For Quizketeers, it's going to be Mina who's going to be doing the memorizing, whereas Jaehee will try to guess what word they have in common. Whereas for the N star, it's going to be J, who's going to be memorizing. And now Yeju will be doing the guessing.
Okay, sounds good. 15 seconds on the clock and our cards. Okay, let's get to memorizing because we only have 5 seconds left.
And 15 seconds gone by just like that. Now, for Quizketeers, once again in the lead, which means Mina will go first with the first word she memorized. What is it?
Crystal.
Crystal.
Yep, that was on there.
Telescope.
Uh-huh.
Cinderella slippers.
Sand.
So far, so
very
good.
Very good.
Revolving door.
Revolving door.
Aquarium.
Aquarium.
Mm-hmm. Marble.
Oh. Marble was unfortunately not on the list.
Which means, Jay, it's your turn.
Bottles.
Any other words?
Beads.
Any more? All right. She was able to get 2 more words than Mina for the 4 Quizketeers. We're going to flip those answers over. And then now, of course, we're going to have to wake her up.
Yes.
Get her gear out.
Let's see if the 3 words that Mina memorized will help Jaehee.
So let's look at those clue words.
Glass.
Glass.
Very quick to answer.
Well, all right. We'll find out if that's the answer. But first, we'll flip that over. And for the N star, Yeju, let's wake her up. There's 5 different words that you're going to work with here. You're trying to find that 1 word in common. Let's take a look at those clue words. What do all of these have in common?
Lens.
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 All right. We have lens from the N star and glass from the 4 Quizketeers. Now, before we do reveal the answer, let's take a look at the other words that they weren't able to memorize.
Mirror.
Ooh, furnace, mirror, bulletproof.
Is
and
it
window.
Clearing things up? Okay, let's find out who's right.
Glass. 4 Quizketeers, they only had 3 clue words, but they were able to get the correct word.
And star, they do look a little bit disappointed. I mean, lens, it was pretty tricky, but, you know, I think the sand might have been something that throws people off, but of course, sand melted turns to glass.
That's
right.
Right. So, with that, at the end of the second round of the second half of Quiz Whiz Junior, let's take a look at the score so far. 4 Quizketeers, they're in a controlling lead with 740 points. N star with 360. But Angela?
Yes.
What are we going to say?
It's not over till it's over.
That's right.
Yes, because guess what? In just 1 to 2 questions in the next round, you can catch up and beat 4 Quizketeers. All right, I see some smiles back on their faces. Okay, let's get moving then. This is the last one. We have
final battle.
At the end of this round, final battle, we will have our final winners for this edition of Quiz Whiz Junior.
That's right, 7 different categories, and the hardest ones are going to be worth 300 points, 200 points, and you have the 100 pointer. So let's take a look at the categories now. All right, some interesting categories. Mm-hmm. We usually pick first, right?
Yes, that's right. We usually go nice and easy, right? We want to we don't want to scare them.
All right. So, let's see. Which one do we want to go for?
Music?
All right. Let's go for music for 100.
The piece you are listening to features the piccolo. The piccolo was made to produce a higher pitch than this instrument. Although similar in looks, the piccolo is about half the size of this instrument.
N star.
Flute.
Flute.
That is correct. See, great start.
You guys have a choice on which category to choose next.
Why science for 100.
For the first time in Korea, this was captured giving birth. This is a famous and unique marine fish, as it is the male that gives birth instead of females. In Greek mythology, this was often depicted as strong creatures that pulled the chariot of Poseidon. What is this?
And star?
Dolphin.
Dolphin?
No, I'm sorry.
Four Quizketeers?
Seahorse.
Seahorse.
Yes, it is seahorse. The male seahorses do give birth. Four Quizketeers, you get to choose the next category.
Sports for 200.
All right.
In this sport, there are many risks of injuries, so athletes are required to carry a handkerchief in case of bleeding. The purpose of this sport is to pin one's opponent on his back until both his or her shoulders touch the mat.
Yes, four Quizketeers.
Wrestling?
Wrestling.
Correct.
Wow, very nice. What was the hint that you heard there? Maybe Greco-Roman and freestyle? Was that the clue that you got? Or do you wrestle?
Pin someone down.
Yes, yeah. Pinning someone down. That is the point of wrestling. Congratulations to you guys. You guys earned 200 points for that. And also, you guys can choose the next category.
World history for 200.
Let's take a listen.
This is the national flag of Chile, which has multiple meanings. The red symbolizes the blood spilt by the natives to achieve independence. The blue stands for the sky and the Pacific Ocean. The white symbolizes this mountain range. This actually happens to be the longest continental mountain range in the world. What is the name of this mountain range?
Yes, four Quizketeers.
The Himalayas.
The Himalayas. Is
no,
not the answer.
Sorry.
And star, you guys have a chance.
3 seconds. Not even a guess.
Yeah, this one was pretty tough, but both teams were unable to answer it. So let's take a look at what the answer actually was. The Andes.
That's right. That's 200 points out the door for both teams.
But four Quizketeers, they still have the chance in choosing the next category, right? Which category will you choose?
Why science for 300?
Let's take a listen.
This year, in New York City, this has been widely used in order to reduce the rodent population. When putting this into a rat burrow, it would naturally melt and release carbon dioxide.
Four Quizketeers.
Dry ice.
Dry ice.
That is correct.
Now with that, it seems like the gap has widened quite a bit and it's going to be very difficult for NSTAR to catch up. But hey, let's finish off strong, right?
As close as possible, please. Next category.
Economy for 200.
Listen carefully to the following dialogue.
Ashtay, what's wrong?
So I got this promotion from my company and I promised all my coworkers that I would buy them gifts and I think it's gonna cost too much money.
Well, you know, instead of looking offline, why don't you try to buy it through social media?
Social media, huh? Well, is that gonna be cheaper?
Yeah, definitely. It's kind of like, think of it like a joint discount purchase of sorts. Much cheaper than offline.
Here is the question. The woman is referring to the buying and selling of goods and services using social media. What is this type of group discount service called?
NSTAR.
Internet shopping.
Not the exact answer.
Four Quizketeers.
Home shopping.
Home shopping. That's not the answer.
And that is going to have to go out the window.
This was a pretty tough one, so why don't we take a look at the answer?
Social commerce.
We have a lot of confused faces there. Yeah, social commerce, right? And it's not a term that we use often, but it is very, very popular, at least amongst people who like to shop on the internet and
stuff. That's right. And sometimes you can find a very good deal. But with that, that leaves us only one category left.
That's right. It's architecture for 300. So let's take a listen.
This structure was commissioned to be built by Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan out of love for his favorite wife. It was continuously worked on and completed over the course of roughly 22 years. It is a mausoleum regarded by many as the leading...
For Quizketeers?
Taj Mahal.
Is it Taj Mahal? Absolutely, a very iconic structure in that country, right?
That's right, which means the four Quizketeers, they add 300 more points into their final tally, and that's already 7 questions we've heard.
Yes, and that brings us to the final score. Four Quizketeers, an amazing job. They maintain their lead from start to finish, 1,640 points, and NSTAR, I loved how they fought till the very end, 460 points.
That's right. Now, before we do say goodbye, we do want to hear from our finalists today. Now, NSTARS, you guys did a great job, but it was pretty tough towards the end. Which one was the hardest round for you guys, Jay?
This one.
Yeah, final battle. The questions are really tough, huh?
But still, NSTAR, you guys did a very, very great job there. Four Quizketeers, congratulations to you guys. You guys are the Quiz Whiz champions today. How do you guys feel, Mina?
We feel really great because we practiced a lot for this.
And it definitely showed. In fact, let's share some of those tips for future teams that want to come out on our show. Perhaps, Jaehee, you can share with us some tips on how to prepare.
Just read many science or social study books.
And so also watch Quiz Whiz Junior.
Most important thing, right?
That's right.
Let's give a big round of applause to our two teams and our winners for Quizketeers.
Well, it was yet another fun episode of Quiz Whiz Junior here, and we're always looking for more schools, more contestants, and just like you said, more friends joining us here in our program.
All right, so if you are interested, then you can check out our website. That's www.arirang.com. Look for Quiz Whiz Junior.
That's right. We're looking forward to seeing more schools, more contestants, and like I said, more friends. But until then, we'll see you guys again same time here on Quiz Whiz Junior.
This Arirang TV program is brought to you by Hwangu Books and Yerimdang Publishing Company Limited.